You know the worst part of owning a Tesla? This giant cable. It looks ugly. It's huge, it's 20 feet long. You gotta fight, fumble with it, try to plug it in, wait for the light. And look at it. Look at what you're left with, this giant snake in the garage, just on the floor. There's gotta be a better way. Spent the last couple weeks putting this together. It's mimicked off of the urban superchargers. I'm calling it my suburban supercharger as I don't live in the city. Got a white shiny front with a Tesla logo, with the gray sides. The charging comes out and can be plugged right in. Put away neatly when done. And not only is it a cabinet to hide all the wires, I actually have a door that shows the wire wrapped around with a storage bin with all the cleaning supplies and the rags. There also happens to be a power outlet right in the center so I can plug my shop back in to clean the car. But it hides all the wiring. As you see the cord coming through, just spits in there, friction right now. I might hook up something to keep it in place, but it hasn't fallen yet. But I have a shelf up here to keep the wire separate. The power comes in across the garage floor, or baseboard, and comes in through the bottom, pops up through into the NEMA 1450 outlet. I then just have the charger plugged in here, wraps around underneath the shelf, comes back up and out the side slot here, and then that will wrap right around when not being used and plugged in over here. You see the door is curved. The curved door was actually a fun project. It's actually, the backing is half inch MDF, as you saw, because I haven't finished painting the inside of it yet. And then I curved some strips on the bandsaw to, there's four strips along the side as they go down, and then glued on is a piece of hardboard that I picked up over at Home Depot. It's only $8 for a full sheet, 4x8 sheet of that. You're not gonna use that much of it if you wanted to make this. And then it is curved on the bottom, just like the ones in Chicago and Boston area, along with, they're numbered and lettered on each one. Ours is I1, because our YouTube channel is I1 Tesla. Plywood sides, 7 inches deep. So there's a nice shelf that's 7 inches deep as well. It just really cleans up the garage. It's so cool when you pull up to that large Tesla logo, bright and shiny, the lights are shining on it. It's like pulling up to a supercharger, but at home. A suburban supercharger. Yeah, but it's really easy to just plug in. Just grab this, swing it over to your car, hit the button. The car's locked right now, so it's gonna take a little bit of time. Wait for that to pop up, and you plug it in. It sits there and charges, nothing on the ground. It is just clean. I couldn't be happier with it. You're probably asking yourself, what the hell do I do if I don't want to back into my garage? My garage is tight. Well, I've got the answer for you. The cord's 20 feet long. Couldn't be happier with my own supercharger in my garage, cleaning it up. I mean, it's a garage, it's not supposed to be clean, but that thing looks awesome. I can make plans online If you'd like detailed plans, I could just make cheap, quick plans, or I can make detailed plans if you'd like to build this, or if you know a carpenter who would like to build it off of the plans. I can have those available. Let me know, comment below. Also, if you're in the Charlotte area, you want me to build it, I can do it. I do have a full cabinet shop and make furniture for a living. But this was a fun, cool project. Just like Eric, he built the regular supercharger in his garage. It took him a long time. This one took me a couple weeks just because I had to wait for some paint to dry, and I had hernia surgery too in the middle of it. Easy as it can be. Easy as it can be. That was stupid.